grade student. My school's name is Magnus Beymanaka. Now I'm gonna tell you Nasreddin Hoca's story. Hoca was in the habit of borrowing things a lot in the village. He had a bad reputation. One day, Hoca went to his neighbor's house and he knocked the door. He said, "Hello, my neighbor. Can I get your cauldron?" And the neighbor said, "I'm not very sure to lend you my cauldron." And Hoca said that. I really need it because we are making a big photo of Ashura for Ramazan, and I promise I will bring it back. Weeks and weeks, and Hoca got the cauldron. He went to his home with the cauldron, and weeks and weeks passed, but Hoca didn't bring the cauldron back. The neighbor went to Hoca's house, and he complained, "Hoca, you promised, but you didn't bring my cauldron back." And Hoca said, "Don't worry, my neighbor, it's here." And the neighbor got insights, and he's surprised because there was a little cauldron in the bigger one. He asked Hoca, "Was this inside?" Hoca answered. Hoca smiled and answered, "While your cauldron was staying with us, it gave birth." And the neighbor got surprised, but he was happy because he had a new cauldron. And a couple of weeks later, Hoca came back to his neighbor's house, and he wants to the cauldron again, and the neighbor didn't hesitate this time, and he said, "Please take it." And Hoca got the cauldron once more, and he went to pack his home. Did Hoca bring the cauldron back? What do you think about that? He didn't bring it back, and the neighbor went back for Hoca's house, and he excited, and he said, "Hoca, where's my cauldron?" Hoca answered sadly, "When your cauldron has died." And the neighbor shocked, "How can a cauldron?" Neighbor said, "How can a cauldron die?" And Hoca answered cunningly, "You are willing to believe that it's gave birth, why don't you believe that it has died?"